Hello everyone, this lecture is about flooring and their method of construction. Let us discuss the floors and the desirable properties of good floors. Floor is a continuous horizontal and supporting surface which is provided to the desired area and it is used for walking and other purposes. Its good properties should be as follows. It should be durable, that means it should be long lasting. The cleaning of this kind of floor should be easy. It should be possibly noiseless, it should provide a good appearance, it should be free from dampness, it should be fire resistant, it should have low maintenance cost and possibly it should also have low initial cost. And what is flooring? Flooring is the process of providing clean, smooth, durable and impervious leveled surface to the desired area. Now let us discuss the types of floors. In this lecture we are talking about ground floors only. So let us discuss the types of ground floors. So first is mud flooring, then murram flooring, brick flooring, flagstone flooring, tile flooring, cement concrete, terrazzo, mosaic, marble, timber, asphalt flooring and rubber flooring. Let us take them one by one. First of all, let us discuss the mud flooring, which is also known as earthen flooring. It is very popular and common in rural areas, especially in the zones which are dry and arid. This is very cheap form of flooring, but the surface obtained is hard, fairly impervious and the construction is easy. This type of flooring is green and eco-friendly because we use locally sourced materials. It remains warm in winter and cool in summer, making it more eco-friendly, and skilled labor is not required for its construction. But it can be damaged due to the concentrated or point loads or scraping action of any other kind of loading. It is not durable as compared to the concrete flooring or tile flooring and it needs frequent maintenance, for example once or twice a week maintenance required. The method of construction of mud flooring is as follows. On a prepared bed, because we are laying the ground floor, the prepared bed is the leveled earth on which we need to lay our floor. So on a prepared bed, a 25 cm thick layer of moist earth is evenly laid and rammed well so as to get a 15 cm thickness. So we need to reduce the 25 cm thick moist earth to 15 cm thickness by ramming. I'll show you the diagram of ramming in this slide only. No water is used during this ramming process and we can add chopped straw, so that chopped straw will prevent the cracking, for future cracking of this kind of flooring. And this flooring needs a weekly maintenance with cow cement and cow dung wash with the 1 ratio of cement and 2 part of cow dung. So this is the ramming process and this is ramming tool, as you can see here. This is the ramming tool. So this person is reducing the thickness of the moist earth to the desired thickness. This is the mud flooring, two types of mud flooring. So sometimes the oil wash is also given to the consolidated mud flooring. So this is refined form of mud flooring and this is slightly unrefined. Next flooring is murram flooring. Murram is disintegrated piece of rock and this floor obtained is cheap, durable and smooth, and this is fairly impervious and construction is easy. And it may remain comfortable during all temperatures, all weather. And if properly maintained, it can provide a very long life. Let us discuss the method of construction of murram flooring. A hard bed is prepared by laying a 5 cm thick layer of broken bricks and then it is rammed. Then on this prepared bed, a 15 cm thick layer of murram is laid. On this, a 25 cm thick layer of powdery variety of murram is uniformly spread. The whole surface is sprinkled with water and rammed until the cream of murram rises to the earth surface. After 12 hours, the surface is again rammed for 3 days. Then surface is smeared with thick paste of cow dung and rammed for 2 days. Then a thin coat of mixture of cow dung and Portland cement in the ratio 4:1 is evenly applied. The surface is wiped clean by hand. For maintaining this type of floor, cement cow dung wash is given occasionally and whenever required. Next type of flooring is brick flooring. These are the two pictures of brick flooring. So brick flooring, these are the properties of brick flooring. These floors can easily be constructed and repaired, and brick floor is durable and a hard surface is obtained. It is cheaper than cement, concrete or timber flooring. It is non-slippery and it is easily repairable, but this type of floor provides a rough surface. And this floor can easily absorb moisture from the surrounding areas and may cause dampness in the building. That's why it is suitable for warehouses, stores, godowns and pavements. Let us see the method of construction of brick flooring. The earth on which this floor is to be laid is consolidated by ramming. Then a 10 to 15 cm thick layer of dry and clean sand is evenly laid. On this 10 cm thick layer of lime concrete or lean cement concrete in the given ratio is laid, compacted and cured to form the base concrete. This is also known as subgrade. At this stage, desired slope is also given for drainage. Then, well-soaked bricks are laid in cement mortar 1:4, 1 part cement, 4 part sand, in any desired bond pattern, herring bond or diagonal bond or any other suitable bond. In case pointing is not to be done, the thickness of joint should not exceed 12 mm and the mortar in the joint is struck off flush. In case the pointing is to be done, the minimum thickness of joint is kept at 6 mm and the pointing may be done as specified. Curing is done for 7 days for this kind of flooring. Let us move on to the next floor, which is flagstone flooring. These are the pictures of flagstone flooring. So flagstone is a laminated sandstone, and stone slab used here may not be of same size, but their size should not be more than 75 cm in length and 35 cm in width, and its thickness should be in the range of 2 to 4 cm. The flooring obtained is hard, durable and resistant to wear and tear, and it is suitable for use in workshops, garages and godowns. Its construction is easy and repair is also easy. Appearance is not very pleasant, so it is not generally preferred in the houses, and surface obtained is rough. Let us see the method of construction of flagstone flooring. First of all, we are going to prepare a subgrade, which is 10 to 15 cm thick lime concrete in 1:4:8 ratio. It is laid over the bed of consolidated earth. On this, well-wetted flagstone is laid in 20 to 25 cm thick layer of bed mortar. That means first we are going to lay 20 to 25 cm thick mortar. On that, we are going to lay the flagstones. After setting, joints are raked out at a depth of 20 mm and flush pointed with 1:3 cement mortar paste. 1:40, 1 vertical, 40 horizontal. Slope is provided for drainage along suitable direction towards the outlet or entrance. Next is tile flooring. Let us discuss its types first. First is terrazzo flooring, terrazzo tile flooring, checkered tile flooring, glazed tile flooring, PVC tile flooring. These are the four types of tile flooring. These are laid over a hard surface like RCC slab. Then the advantages associated with tile floorings are as follows. The surface obtained is non-absorbent, easily repairable. We can repair the single piece, which one is broken. Durable, this floor is durable. It provides a pleasing appearance. It is a very quick laying floor and it provides a good strength. And the disadvantages are the cost of construction is very high, and the floor becomes very slippery when it is wet. Especially the glazed tile flooring becomes very slippery if they are wet. So these are the four types of tile. This first one is terrazzo tile. These are the checkered tiles. These are glazed tiles. And these are PVC tiles. So let us discuss the terrazzo tile flooring, its method of construction. First of all, let us discuss what terrazzo tiles are. Terrazzo tiles are made under hydraulic pressure and composed of two layers. The top layer, which is known as upper layer, is 5 to 6 mm thick and made of cement, marble chips and pigments. The lower layer is made of 1:3 cement sand mix. And these are the size of the terrazzo tiles. 200 into 200 into 20 mm, 215 to 215 to 22 mm, 300 × 300 × 25 mm, 20, 22, 25 mm being the thickness of these tiles. So this man is laying terrazzo tiles, this man is laying the glazed tiles, and these are checkered tiles, and this man is laying the PVC tiles. Construction method of terrazzo tile flooring. So we are laying the ground floors. So let us discuss the method of construction of ground floors. The earth on which the floor is to be laid is consolidated with ramming. Then a 10 centimeter thick layer of lime concrete or lean cement concrete is laid, which is base concrete or subgrade. Then a thin layer of lime or cement mortar is spread with the help of screed battens. When the surface mortar hardens sufficiently, a 6 mm thick bed of wet cement is laid, and then over this the specified tiles are laid. The surplus mortar which comes out of the joint is cleaned off. After 3 days the joints are rubbed with carborum dump stone to chip off all the projecting edges. Rubbing should not be done in case of glazed tiles. The surface is polished by rubbing with a softer variety of carborundum or pumic stone. Curing is done for 7 days. The surface is finally washed with soap. The following types of tiles can also be used. We can use terrazzo tiles. They are available in the same sizes as terrazzo tiles. And the glazed tiles are available in following size: 100 × 100 × 5 to 6 mm thickness, 150 × 150 × 5 to 6 mm. In this case, joints are cleaned up to 2 to 3 cm depth with wire brush and flush pointed with white or colored cement to maintain the beauty of floor. Next flooring is PVC tile flooring. It is a decorative floor which is resilient, smooth, and can be cleaned easily. Tiles are laid on dry surface and at ambient temperature. Adhesive is placed on backside of the tiles and it is allowed to partially set after placing it for, let us say, for 30 minutes. After laying, tiles are pressed with wooden rollers weighing about 5 kg. Extra adhesive which is coming over the tiles is cleaned off and surface is cleaned with soap water before use. This floor may get damaged due to any burning object falling on it because tiles are made up of PVC. Next, and a very commonly used type of flooring is cement concrete flooring. According to the method of finishing of the topping, the cement concrete flooring can be classified into following two types. One, non-monolithic or bonded floor finish concrete floor, and second is monolithic floor finish concrete floor. The advantages of cement concrete flooring are as follows. The surface is hard and durable, and it provides a smooth and non-absorbent surface, and this kind of flooring is more fire resistant. They provide more sanitary surface as their cleaning is very easy and washing is also very easy. They are economical as they need very little maintenance. They can be finished with a pleasing appearance. So let us discuss their method of construction. We have just discussed the two types of cement concrete floor. Let us discuss the method of construction of the first one, which is non-monolithic or bonded floor finish concrete floor. Its method of construction. First, we need to prepare the subgrade, and we are discussing the ground floors. So the first step is to prepare the earth by consolidation using the ramming tool. Then a 10 centimeter thick layer of clean sand is spread over it, consolidated, and the desired slope is given here. Then we lay the base concrete, which is 10 centimeter thick lime concrete or lean cement concrete in 1:5:10, 1 part cement, 5 parts sand, and 10 part gravel is laid, forming the base concrete. And the topping is 4 centimeter thick cement concrete in ratio 1:2:4 is laid on the third day of laying base cement concrete, thus forming a non-monolithic construction. So we are laying the topping after 3 days of laying of base concrete, so creating it as non-monolithic construction. Then topping can also be laid by two methods: topping laid in single layer, The topping consists of a single layer of cement concrete with its thickness equal to 4 cm, or topping can be laid in two layers. The topping consists of a 2.5 cm thick cement concrete in ratio 1 is to 3 is to 6, 1 part cement, 3 part sand and 6 part gravel, on which 1.5 thick cement concrete is laid monolithically. So we have two layers of varying thickness, 2.5 cm thickness and 1.5 cm thickness in this case, whereas in previous case when we have used the single layer, the thickness is only 4 cm. The floor area may be divided into panels of not more than 2 meter into 2 meter size with the help of glass struts. Then topping must be layered on cement slurry to ensure proper bonding with the base concrete. Top surface is stamped and floated with wooden float till cream of mortar comes on the top of the surface. Then curing is done for 10 days. The next one is monolithic floor finish concrete floor. In this flooring, the topping consists of 2 cm thick cement concrete in ratio 1 is to 2 is to 4, which is laid monolithically with the base concrete. Let us discuss the method of construction of this floor. The surface of murram or earth filling is leveled, well watered and rammed. Suppose we want to lay this flooring on earth or we want to lay this on the layer of murram, we can provide a layer of broken bricks below the base subgrade or base concrete, or we can provide a layer of murram below the subgrade or base, or we can directly place this subgrade on the earth if it is not very moist. Then a 10 cm thick layer of clean and dry sand is spread over it. When monolithic construction is desired, then 5 cm to 10 cm thick dry brick or rubble filling is laid. 10 cm thick layer of base concrete consisting of cement concrete 1 is to 4 is to 8 or lean cement concrete. This is lime concrete. Lean cement concrete 1 is to 8 is to 16 is laid. The topping, 2 cm thick layer of cement concrete is laid after 45 minutes to 4 hours of laying the base concrete. So the difference between monolithic and non-monolithical is the time of laying of topping. Here we are laying the topping within 45 minutes to 4 hours, whereas in previous case we were laying the topping after 3 days of laying the base concrete. So this is the tool for tamping and this is the float which is used to screed off the concrete. These are the two pictures of cement concrete flooring and these are screed battens. So these people are screeding the concrete with the help of screed battens. Screed battens are the device used in construction. Next is terrazzo flooring, and from these pictures you can see that this is a very common type of flooring used everywhere in India or all over the world. So what is terrazzo? Terrazzo is 3 part marble chips and 1 part white or colored cement. And for this type of flooring, a subgrade or base concrete is laid in same ways as described for cement concrete floor. Then whole area is divided into number of panels of size not more than 2 meter into 2 meter as discussed in cement concrete flooring, with the help of glass strips or copper, aluminium or brass strips with section of 1.5 into 25 mm. Then a 40 mm thick terrazzo flooring is made of 6 mm terrazzo and 34 mm thick underlayer of concrete. So 6 mm layer of terrazzo placed over 34 mm thick layer of concreting. And prior to laying under layer concrete, the surface is wetted with water. Under layer concrete has a ratio of 1 is to 2 is to 4 is laid, consolidated, leveled and finished to the rough surface. After hardening of an under layer concrete, a plastic mix of terrazzo is laid over it and it is stamped with the tamping tool. And 80% of the marble chips should be seen on the top surface. After floating, the surface is dried for 12 to 18 hours. Then surface is cured under standing water for 2 days. Then grinding is done with coarse stone with number 60. And surface is washed and if any holes are observed on the surface of the flooring, then they are filled with cement paste. Then again curing is done for 5 to 7 days, and then we do again grinding with a fine grade stone. Generally the number of this stone is 120. Again the surface is cleaned, repaired for any holes, cured again, and grinding is done with a very fine grade stone, number 320. Then surface is washed with very diluted oxalic acid solution, which has a very good rinsing properties. Polishing is done with the felt fitted polishing machine. This is final polishing of terrazzo flooring. Next is mosaic flooring. The floor with top layer consisting of mosaic tiles or small regular cubes, square or hexagons embedded in a cementing mixture is known as mosaic flooring, as you can see in this picture. So this is mosaic flooring. Let us see the construction method, since we are discussing only ground floors. So first step is to consolidate the earth with ramming, then a 10 cm thick layer of clean sand is spread over which a 10 cm thick lime concrete or lean cement concrete is laid, which is the base concrete or subgrade. Then on the top of this, a base course of 5 cm thick lime mortar or cement mortar or lime and surkhi mortar is laid. Surkhi is brick powder. So if we are using lime and surkhi mortar, we are taking one part of lime and two part of surkhi. The mortar is laid in small area so that the mortar may not get dried before finishing the wearing course. And a 3 mm thick cementing mixture is spread. The cementing mixture consists of one part of pozzolana, one part of marble chips, and two parts of slaked lime. Then after 4 hours, patterns are formed on the top of cementing material. Now the tiles of regular shaped marble cubes are hammered in the mortar along the outline of the pattern. The inner spaces are filled with the colored pieces of the marble. Then a roller 30 cm in diameter and 50 cm in length is passed gently over the surface. Water is sprinkled to work up the mortar between the marble pieces. The surface is then rubbed with pumice stone fixed to the wooden handle about 1.5 meter long. The surface is then allowed to dry up for 2 weeks before use. Next is marble flooring. Marble flooring gives a rich look to the building, but it has a high initial cost. Thickness of marble slab varies from 20 to 40 mm. Let us discuss the method of construction of marble flooring. Flooring is laid on the subgrade of cement concrete slab. Subgrade is cleaned and wetted. Then 1:4 bedding cement coarse sand cement with coarse sand. So one part cement and four part coarse sand, or 1:1:1 putty surkhi and coarse sand mortar. One part putty, one part surkhi, and one part coarse sand is taken. And it is laid in 20 mm thickness as bedding mortar. On this, marble slab is laid, pressed and tapped with mallet. Mallet is a wooden hammer to the level with adjoining slabs. Cement slurry is spread over the all surfaces. Joints between the slabs are kept paper thin, and surface is cleaned and cured for 7 days. So again, we are showing the picture of screed batten and wooden mallet as discussed in previous slides. So this is the construction of the floor showing different layers. So we have base concrete or subgrade. Then over the subgrade we can have a layer of insulation, DPC layer. On that another layer of concrete is provided on the top of this floor finishing provided. For example, we can provide the PVC tiles or terrazzo tiles or any other tiles we can provide on the top of this screed. This screed is a layer of concrete. This is marble flooring. This one is marble flooring. Next one is timber flooring. Timber flooring is used in hilly areas as wood is easily available there, and it is also used in dancing halls and auditoriums. And in this case, prevention of dampness is very important. So this is a picture of wooden flooring. This is the typical section of wooden flooring, and we'll be discussing this in detail. If you want to look into the various parts of this, you can pause the video. Let us discuss the construction method. So entire area on which the timber flooring is to be laid is covered with a 15 centimeter thick layer of cement concrete. Let's assume this is the 15 centimeter thickness, thick layer of cement concrete. This one, we are laying the ground floor. The first step is to lay cement concrete slab of thickness 15 centimeter. Then boarding supported on the timber joist, which are nailed to the wall plate and supported on the sleeper walls. So if we look from here, this is boarding. Boarding is supported on the joist. These are the timber joist, which are fixed in the wall here at the end wall. And this is sleeper wall, and they are resting on the or supported on the sleeper wall. So this is boarding, the top layer of the timber flooring. Then we have this, these are the joist, timber joist or flooring joist or bridging, and they are resting on the sleeper walls. This is end wall, they are fixed here, built in the wall, and these are the sleeper walls, which are provided at some interval. So these sleeper walls are provided at the rate 1.8 meter spacing, and they are 10 centimeter thick. That means this is a half brick thick wall. So they are provided at every 1.8 meters. So after 1.8 meter, we'll have another sleeper wall. Sleeper plates are fixed on the top of sleeper wall. These are sleeper plates. This layer, this is sleeper plate. And the DPC is provided just below these plates. So DPC is provided just below these plates. Next flooring is asphalt flooring. And asphalt is also known as bitumen. This is a sticky, black and highly viscous liquid or semi-solid form of petroleum. And asphalt flooring is dustless, elastic, waterproof, acid-proof. It gives a very pleasant look. It is noiseless and non-slippery. Let us discuss the method of construction. So first of all, we are going to prepare the mastic asphalt. Asphalt is melted and sand is added to make 2:1 ratio of sand to asphalt. While heating it at the stage when it emits light brown smoke, it is ready to pour. Laying mastic asphalt is laid on prepared cement concrete bed in uniform thickness. This thickness is 13 to 25 mm. And before it becomes hard, sand is sifted over it. That means sand is sprinkled over it. Second layer of asphalt is laid and then finished. So this is asphalt flooring, bituminous asphalt flooring. So this is concrete, the bottom layer of concrete. On this, another layer of concrete is provided. Then DPC may be provided, or this is the separating layer. The DPC is provided below the screed, and this is mastic asphalt, a layer of mastic asphalt. As you can see, this provides, this kind of flooring provide a very good look, rich look to the building. Last one is rubber flooring. Rubber flooring is noiseless, comfortable, clean and durable, and it is used in gymnasium because it is non-slippery, cafeterias, hospitals, etc. The thickness of rubber tile is not more than 10 mm. And rubber sheet tiles are laid over the concrete. Method of construction is same as that for PVC flooring. And it is most durable kind of flooring, but it is very expensive also. And if oil is present on this flooring, it may become slippery. This is rubber flooring. Thank you. That's all with the ground floors. Thank you for listening.